lot of the children in my class, especially when we're writing English. They'll write, I like this, I like that, I have this, I have that. So have and like is definitely out. So when somebody says I like, I say no, I like. Because our class is print rich. A print rich classroom is a classroom that basically has useful information. And it could be words, it could be pictures. So whether it instructs them on what to do next, or it tells them what group is coming to read with me on the mat. Basically, it's information that you use on a regular basis. So, no, I have, go find other words to write about, because you have them, they're here, they're all around you. Look around you, write a lovely sentence. You're too old for I like, I have. Children come to school with different vocabularies. The children in my class, their vocabulary in isiXhosa is much more than it is in English. The parents at home speak isiXhosa, so isiXhosa is a home language. So if you come to the class for the lesson and you haven't planned, what vocabulary are you going to teach? Are you just going to read through the book and assume that that's what they know? But if you sit down, look at it, you know their level, you know how to, you know the words that you've actually introduced to them. Look at those, write them on a flashcard. And you introduce the vocab before you start reading. Because if people are seeing so many words that they don't understand, again, the meaning is lost. But if I've shown you this word, zazingamaqhophololo, before we start and we discuss it and we talk about it, when you see it, it's not new. So I haven't lost you. And if you do and you do it properly and you keep using those words and you have those words in the classroom that they can see and you refer to those words regularly, definitely that will build their vocabulary. We get new words on a daily basis. They have a word bank. And I say to you, any word that you come across that you don't understand, go find your bank and deposit some words in there. The more words you have, the richer you are. You know, in a classroom, you always find those that want to please the teacher the most. And they compete about it. And you find those who are like, ah, oh, please, we're two. If I have two words, and I have to tell you, yeah, I'm funding. Why do you only have three words? Yeah, I'm Dazeka, you are poor, poverty. And then people don't want to be poor. They go, oh, okay, maybe I should get more words. Because then it indicates, if you don't deposit, Mdase, you have very little to work with. I won't always be there, and I know in some spaces, you by yourself. My children have library books that they take home. Né? So when they're reading, they need to understand, if I don't understand a word, how can I make myself understand it? What do? There are things called dictionaries that are there that could help you. So they quickly go and look a word up. So they know how to use a dictionary, and they know how to pick the word that will make the most meaning in that sentence. Whenever people are reading, it's not just a reading and you say, oh, you're so fluent in the reading. As the teacher, you need to make sure that you ask the question. Whenever people are reading, it's not just a reading and you say, oh, you're so fluent in the reading.